Okay, so another thing we will learn about this strings, characters, functions is getch. We have been using this for a while now. So getch. So two functions, getch and putch, are present. What are their meaning? Now, to understand the meaning of getch and putch, let me just explore scanf once more. See, when you scanf with %c, say you scanf with %c and receive it in say ampersand, say any character ch. So you declared a character character ch, and then you scanf using %c. So you may tell the user to enter a character or scanf %c, say printf is, I will write later. So if you have this, after this you say printf %c followed by ch, you print the character. So you scan the character, after that you print the character. So how it happens, I just want to explore once more. See, alt or enter, you are doing one character, statement missing, okay. So you printf this ch, what you have done, you have just scanned a character and printed a character. How it works, just exploring once more. Say you need to enter a character, say you enter y, it does not print immediately, does it? No, in fact, it has not started to scan yet. Because remember, until and unless you press enter, scanf does not begin. So u I r f g h b, whatever you do, but you had scanned only one character. See, once you press enter, only then scanning begins, and it will scan %c, that is only one character, and print that. See, it prints only y. Your u I r f g h b are all neglected, but you entered. What is happening when you are entering this y u I r f g h b? Everything was entering the buffer, and once you press the enter, scanf started functioning and it started scanning from the buffer. You have written only %c, as a result it is scanning only one character. See, again I explain, scanf %c ampersand ch, say you write hello, h e l l o, you can write, but it is waiting. Until and unless you press the enter, scanning does not begin. Because everything you are writing is entering your keyboard buffer. H is entering the buffer, E is entering the buffer, L is entering the buffer, L is entering the buffer, O is entering the buffer. Now you press enter. As soon as you press enter, what happens? Scanning starts. Now scanning says %c. So what it does? It scans only one character, that is H. And you are printing it. What does it print? It prints only H. Your E, L, L, O, where are they? They are still in the buffer. If you scan again, again E, L, L, O will be considered, because they are there in the waiting in the buffer to be scanned. Now, what is the difference? Getch also is like scanf, printf, scanf %c. Getch also scans a character. Like scanf %c scans one character, getch also scans one character. The difference is, getch does not wait for an enter. It does not use the keyboard buffer. I repeat, scanf, when you enter this, all these are entering the buffer, waiting to be scanned. When you press enter, scanning happens. Scanning happens from where? The buffer. So scanf waits for enter and then scans from the buffer. Whatever you enter, enters the buffer. Getch does not use the keyboard buffer. Anything that you enter, any character that you enter, is immediately scanned without the use of buffer. As a result, if you press H, immediately getch will return. It will not wait for the pressing of enter. It will not wait for pressing of enter, it will immediately return. It will immediately return from getch function. It does not wait for the buffer. So as a result, what happens? what happens is this getCH will scan the character and you can receive the character immediately in CH. So if you press something, press a key, it will not wait for enter, it will immediately come out. Say this program, suppose this getCH is not there, only one getCH. See, it will scan. If you press anything, say I'm just pressing one key, P, immediately it breaks out. It does not wait for the pressing of enter. It only gets immediately as soon as you press any character, it comes out of it. It does not use the keyboard buffer. Now see, the thing is, if you return to the black screen, see, nothing has been printed. You just returned to the black screen and wanted to find. Nothing has been printed. The P that you entered, that has also not been typed inside. Because remember, when you do scanf, say you enter hello, H-E-L-L-O is firstly printed on the screen while you are entering. That is because whatever you are printing is entering the keyboard buffer and also getting printed on the screen. But getCH does not make use of any buffer. As a result, what happens? As a result, neither it allows printing on the screen. Say you type the character in, that character is not printed on screen. That character is not printed on screen, only one character, that is, if no character is printed on screen. But over here, if you print that character, printf, %c, followed by ch, then that ch will enter because of your printf. See, alter, enter. Okay, the comma was missing. Anyway, alter, enter. So say I enter P. See, this P, you have gone out. As soon as you pressed P, you got out of the screen because there is no more getCH. The getCH, that P, immediately returned P in CH. Now you printed that CH. So that CHP is printed on screen. If you return to the black screen, you see that P is printed. But this P is printed because of what? Because of your printf. The getCH does not allow printing on screen, nor does it use the keyboard buffer. As soon as you press, immediately getCH returns and puts the value in CH. Do you get it? If instead of this getCH, I would have written scanf, scanf %c ampersand CH, then what would have happened? Then what would have happened is, you see, run this, you enter P. P is entered, it is not going out immediately because the screen is waiting for pressing enter. As soon as you press enter, it will, what does it do? It does not print anything. It does not print anything because print a %cch you have written, this getCH it was waiting for. I should have commented this. Anyway, so print a %c ampersand CH, print a %cch. I have printed. See what happens? I have pressed P. It is waiting for your enter. As soon as you press enter, it will go out because there is no getCH at end, so it goes out. But this printf, has it happened? Yes, it has happened. Go back to the black screen and see two p's, because when you did scanf, you are entering the p. The p that you entered is entering your buffer. The p that you entered is entering your buffer and also getting printed on screen. And printf %cch, that also prints the p. But if you now comment the scanf and open the getCH, see, this getCH, if you enter P, this getCH, if you enter P, that P that you entered will not be printed on screen. This P that you entered will not be, if you enter P, it will not be printed on screen because getCH does not allow printing on screen. GetCH does not allow input to the buffer. So it neither use the input buffer nor does it use the output buffer. Only the key that you press immediately is returned from GetCH and CH receives that. Now you print this %cch. Now this P will be printed. So you know that, understand the difference. I once more, alter, enter. You press P, it will go out. You go back to the screen, you will find only one P, which is printed because of the printf, this printf. Now you remove the scanf comment and comment the get ch. Now see what happens, 2p will be printed. This p is printed because you are printing. Scanf allows the output buffer to be printed to, that is the screen to be printed to, and also p enters the buffer. As soon as you press enter, then it goes out, but see, 2p's have been printed. It goes out because the get ch is not there at the end. I think you understand this. So it prints p and goes out. So 2p's are there. Once more, Alt+F5, see, 2p's are there in the buffer when I go back to the on the screen, when you go back to the screen. But getch only allows the returning. It returns as soon as you print one key. Once more, enter, enter. Say U. I press U. It goes out. Does not allow printing. And goes out because it does not wait for enter. It does not use the keyboard buffer. Immediately returns the character. Does not print, allow the print on screen. And does not allow the keyboard buffer. Does not allow the character to enter the buffer. Immediately returns ch. So print a person, see that ch is printed. Now you go to the screen, you see that u has been printed. Because of the print a person, see. So like get ch, there is put ch. But put ch and print a person, see, is absolutely same. Printf person C, if you print by person C, it is same as put CH. So put CH, CH will also print. You can check. Alt or enter. Now if I press Y, Y will not be printed on screen and will immediately go out. See, it goes out because you printed, you typed that Y, but Y was not typed on screen and it neither end nor did it enter the keyboard buffer. But it immediately returned that Y which is received in CH immediately. That Y has been printed on screen because of put CH. But because there is no more get CH, it immediately comes out. If you return to the screen, you will see this Y. So do you remember how we use get CH at the end of every function? We used to wait, make your output screen wait for a key. Otherwise, you would not have been able to see the screen, black screen. Get CH made you wait in the screen. So that you can see the output and then pressing a key brings you out. Get CH allows just one key press. So one key press, it brought it out always. So you can keep this get CH also just to make the screen wait. So see what will happen now. The screen will wait. You enter P. This P is not allowed to output on the buffer because of the get CH. But the printf, the put CH will print that P. So the PI typed, put CH type printed it. If I press enter, it will go out. Go back to the screen, see 1P only. But scanf is allowing 2Ps because 1P is printed because of the scanf. When you are typing it, it is getting printed. I think I have explained it enough. You have understood it. So how is this used at all? See, when you press a key, that key is not printed on screen. When do you want it? You want it while inputting a password. When you are inputting a password, say you are entering a password, that password you are entering, say I am printing, my password is hello123. This is my password. If this is my password, when I am typing this hello123, you don't want this hello123 to get into your screen. Is not so. You do not allow this, want this hello123 to go on screen. So when you will, if you scan this hello123 through a getch in a for loop, then you will type H, you will type E, you will type L, you will type L, but nothing will be printed on screen because getch does not allow printing on screen. Getch does not allow printing on screen, so nothing will be printed on screen. Instead of that, manually you can print a star. By your program, you can put CH a star, but getch does not allow that character to be printed. But then, anything that you get from getch, you can put it in an array. So that password is there in your array which you can print later. Do you get it? Say I put this getch in a for loop. So I print hello123, I type. Nothing will be printed on screen because it is not allowed. Then you receive all this hello in an array. That you receive it and then you print it later. But password is there in your hand. I think you get this. This is one thing. Another thing is, you remember, I always said enter is 10. Is not so? But actually speaking, 10 is returning. 10 is not actually an enters function. Enters ASCII is 13. 10 is the ASCII of home. Like if you press home key, what happens? It goes back to the front of that line only. 10 is actually that. But remember in enter, when you press enter, what happens? If you press enter over here, say over here, what will happen? It will go to the next line and then go to the start of the screen. So because it is going to the start of the screen, it is making use of 10. 10 is going to the start of the screen. So when you are pressing enter, it is going to the next line, new line, and then going to the start of the screen. So enter is taking help of two things. One thing is going down and then going to the start of the screen. So enter consists of going down and also 10. That's why you used to work on 10. But getch will not use a buffer, it will return the character immediately. So 10, if you check for 10 for enter, getch will not work. If you have to check for enter, you have to check for 13. Because 13 is the code for enter. You get my point? 13 is the code for that. So how to write a program of this password? Let me get rid of this whole thing and write a new program for password. I delete this. I will write a password program. What to do? For that, I use a password array, maybe 20 characters maximum. Now what I will do is, in a for loop, I will scan, or I will getch. For I equal to 0, no endpoint, I plus plus. See, what I will do is, I will do getch and get that in pwdi. So what happens? I is 0. PWD 0 is your first character. Then I is 1. PWD 1 is your next character. So if you enter hello 123, what will happen? If you enter hello 123 in the loop, what will happen? I is 0. So immediately I is 0 means H will be returned. PWD 0 will be H. Next in the for loop, I will be 1. E will enter PWD 1. I is 2. L will enter PWD 2. And so on. So enter hello 123 will be entered. As soon as you press enter, you want to break out. How to do that? For that, you have to check if the character that you have got from getch is 13. That is enter. What will you do? If you get 13, what will you do? You will immediately break out of the loop. But one thing you need to do, it is a character array. So at that point, you must enter. For that I, you must put in 0. You don't want 13. You want a null character to enter the end character point. So you do pwd I equal to 0 at that point you enter and break out. So what is happening? See, H is entering pwd 0. E is entering pwd 1. L is entering pwd 2. L is entering pwd 3. And so on. 1, 2, 3. 3 is entering also. 3 is entering pwd 7. Now you press enter. So enter enters PWD 8, 13 enters PWD 8, but PWD 8 is equal to 13. So you break out PWD 8, you make 0. That is, you put the 0 manually in this point and break out. Because at the end of the string, there must be the 0 present. So this PWD I you have print, sorry, this PWD I you have totally got this PWD. Now the password is ready with you. What can you do? You can print the password, printf, because it is there in PWD character array. You can say the password is, at the end you just print the password. You may not print. See, in actual programs, you may keep the password intact with you. You should not print. I am printing over here to show that the password has been scanned. You get my point? Getch has got the characters, but what is the difference? Why not scanf? You could have done it by scanf%c also, but scanf%c would have written all the characters on screen. Isn't it so? But over here, what will happen, you see? I press or I try to run it. Oh, int I not declared, sorry. You must declare int I also. Isn't it so? Anything else you have needed? No. So let me save it, sorry. Let me save it first. I save it. Now I try to run it. So see, I will enter hello 123. I type H, not seen on screen. I type E, not seen on screen. I type L, not seen on screen. I again press L, not seen on screen. I press O, not seen on screen. 1, 2, 3, not seen on screen. Now I press enter. The password is hello 123. Do you get my point? To make this thing more appropriate, what you can do is, for every character you enter, you are getting this in getch, from getch you are getting the character. For every character you enter, you put ch. Put ch is same as print a person c. You put ch a star, which is normally done while entering passwords. Now see what will happen. What happened? Oh, okay. Put ch only accepts characters, na? You have done string. Put ch only allows characters. Put s will do like that, double string. But if you have to enter character, it must be one character only. So it must be within single quotes. Anyway, so try to run it. See, I will press capital H. Star is printed because H has been scanned. See, H has been scanned within ch, has been returned in ch by get ch in your PWD0. But it is not allowing to be print, and manually you have forcefully printed this star. Now I press E, I press L, I press L, I press O, I press 1, I press 2, I press 3. Now I press enter. What will happen? The password is hello123. You can put a slash n over here. Isn't it so? So once more, now I type my password. Let my password be UEM Jaipur. I press UEM space JAIPUR. Now I press enter. The password is UEM Jaipur. You understand this? So this is how getch and putch is also used. So this is a program, another program which I thought that you should all understand. So this is all about it. We'll come back with a next lesson where we'll do more things. We'll learn more new things about C. Thank you so much. We'll come back.